and this is Burn, and I'm here to have a movie talk. Come on, baby, let's get ready! Yeah! So, sad news in the DC world.
No!
Come on. Come on. Really, we really have to do all of this, right? Because I'm telling you, James, you better have the best. You came from Marvel. You've done well with a series of movies that includes Guardians of the Galaxy. And you did good with the Suicide Squad. You know, but I'm telling you right now, you better be on your A game of whatever you're going to create. You're going to make a Superman movie. I don't know why. Why? Reason why I'm saying why. Why could you not keep Henry Cavill? No more Superman. No more Ben Affleck. Ben! I have a list. Not only that, you got no Cyborg, Ray Fisher. I heard he was on the shit list in tweet. Sorry, man. Then we got no more Aquaman. But Jason Momoa is going to play Lobo, which we already knew that.
Worst thing in the world. All right, this needs to be documented. What's the date today? The 6th of November. The greatest news, some of the greatest news in my life just happened. I can't say anything about it. Fuck yes! Oh! I can't wait to share with you, but they won't let me share anything. I want you to remember this date, November 6th. Mwah! You know who you are. Mwah! Mwah, maestro. Mwah!
Then, we don't know what's going on with Gal. I'm gonna be honest with you. With her and that, Patty? Zach did a better job than Wonder Woman than Patty did, to be honest with you. She did a great job in the first movie, but the second one was horrible. Horrible. I hated it, because how are you gonna have Wonder Woman, I'm thinking about Henry, that's why I'm all messed up. How are you gonna have Wonder Woman fly, then she's in a plane? What's the sense of having her in a plane when she can fly? See, that could have continued to another story. The next movie, then you can make her fly, but you did everything in one shot. So I kind of didn't like that. Then you give her golden wings. This is the kicker for me. After this Shazam movie, it's done? Bro, I'm telling you, your DC studio better be on point. I already know you're not competing with Marvel. Oh, you can't. Even though Marvel's doing horribly right now, but I know you can't. Only thing Marvel got going was No Way Home. That was the best movie they had. I'm sorry, Doctor Strange was horrible. Alright, it wasn't horrible. It was just... That's how I felt. And I'm a Sam Raimi fan, too. Also, Black Panther. It was good, but it's... Let me tell you about Marvel. They have the same formula. Same formula in all these superhero movies. The Avengers. Avengers! Hey! Second movie. Avengers! Hey! Civil War. Whatever you are. Infinity War. Avengers. And Endgame. Avengers. Assemble. It's the same formula. Same thing in Black Panther. Same thing. Felt like I was watching Endgame with the fight scene. Now, Shazam. After the second one, that's it. What is the deal? What is the deal? Then you have the nerve to be like, maybe we should have Robert Pattinson as Batman. No. Stick to that world right there. Leave him there. Do your studio, and that's it. Which they have decided to do so. Thank you. Don't put Batman into your new world. Because I'm liking Batman alone of what he's doing. Just like you got that Joker and Lady Gaga doing this new movie. I like the first movie, but I don't know how I'm going to feel about this second movie. That child know my pain. You hear that? That's my pain for DC right now. Snyderverse! Then Miller, whatever it is. Ezra? Who named that child that? Miller. Nobody knows what's going on with him. Is he gonna stay? Is he gonna leave? Nobody knows what's going on. I mean, like, it's like, come on, what are you doing with that? With this dude? I hear things. I'm watching all these videos about how they're saying this Flash movie, it's going to be the No Way Home type. And I'm hearing great reviews about this Flash movie, which I'm so anticipating on watching. But I hate the fact how they cut everything out. Superman was supposed to be in it, gone. Wonder Woman is supposed to be in it, gone. It's like you'll do this, and then you'll do that, and you'll do this, and you'll do that. And it's back and forth. And not only that, I'm surprised Michael Keaton is still in it. Because we already heard about how Batgirl is done. We already heard about somebody else's... Oh, you know... I feel bad. Really bad. For Michael Keaton. Granted, he's old. Give that man his third movie of Batman. Give it to him. He was about to do it. He was about to give Batman his third movie. And it was like, from what I heard, it sounded great. Had a great story to it. You had Michelle Pfeiffer coming back as Catwoman. Bro, exciting. I'm like, because she's already in Marvel doing this thing with the Ant-Man, whatever you want to call it. So she's like, she would be perfect. And she's not like she's in bad shape. This is great. And the storyline was going along with, of course, Batman Beyond. That made sense. But of course, you guys, James, Safford, whatever the hell his name is, name that guy that name, mess it up. Close the world. So now there's an NWO. It's a New World Order of DC. Exactly. New World of DC. We don't know what's going on. We don't know what he's doing. We don't know what's the deal. And then, not only that, I wasn't too crazy about it. I liked the movie, but I didn't like the way how he portrayed, like, he can go against all the Justice League, this Black Adam. So The Rock stepped down and left because they are not giving him his Black Adam sequel. Because they took Henry Cavill out, Superman.
No!
And it's just all a hot mess. One minute you have Superman announcing that he's back.
Hey everyone, I wanted to wait until the weekend was over before posting this. Because I wanted to give you all a chance to watch Black Adam. But now that plenty of you have, I wanted to make it official that I am back as Superman. And the image you see on this post and what you saw in Black Adam are just a very small taste of things to come. So there's a lot to be thankful for, and I'll get to that in time. But I wanted to thank you guys most of all. Thank you for your support and thank you for your patience. I promise it will be rewarded.
Poor guy, he left the Witcher series to be like the man. That's how devoted he was. He left the Witcher to come to you guys, DC. He came to you guys to devote his act on Superman. And you know, that was like, the whole world was like, yes! He is back! And then you guys messed it up.
Did you know Henry Cavill just announced that he is no longer going to be playing Superman and a new Superman movie is coming, written by James Gunn. This must really hurt after being in the end credits for Black Adam and filming an appearance for the Flash movie. The big question is, who do you think should play Superman next?
No! No, he's gone! No! Ah! 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 And then you want Ben to direct. That's like, to me, I don't know. I would feel funny about that. We don't want you. I said, Ben, okay. We love you. You know we love you. You know, they give that bit. We love you, but we're changing things around. We want younger cast. Oh, don't think we didn't love your Batman. We love your Batman. But what we're gonna do is different. But we still want you. You can direct. I know Ben was like, okay. Me, I'll feel funny about that. But then again, I would have directed my Batman movie, even though I'm not in it no more, with someone else. Now, that's the problem. Who are they going to cast for Superman and Batman in this DC studio universe? That's what I want to know. You better have somebody good, and you better have the right costumes for this, because I am sick and tired. Well, we saw drawings like Batman with a collar. They already did that with Robert Pattinson. But Superman, he just looked goofy. Like, I don't know. Henry, he worked out. I mean, he... So did Ben. Ben worked out. Yeah. You mother suckers. Who's going to be Cyborg now? Is there going to be a Shazam? Another Shazam? You took Dave out. Black Adam? Okay, sera. That's another story. But what I'm hurt is what we're never going to see. And you know where I'm going with this. We're never going to see Zack Snyder's Justice League. We're never going to see 2 and 3. We're never going to see the nightmares of what it must become. We're never going to see any of that. Because you know why? Thank you, James. You took our world and just went... Even I was watching Black Adam and I watched the ending and I was all excited again. And then I remember we're never going to see that either. Superman versus Black Adam, which is really supposed to be Black Adam versus Shazam. Or it would have been a good movie, just like what they did with the cartoon. Black Adam going against Superman and Shazam helping it. That would have been a great movie with all three of them together. Guess what? Nope. It's like, come on, guys. You, Warner Brothers, you guys are so unbalanced. You're so unbalanced. You don't know what to do. You have producers and executives and whoever, and they just think,
yeah, sure, just do that. Just do that. And
you just put out the worst and the best, but more of the worst. I did not have a problem with Batman versus Superman. The extended version should have been out in theaters. My opinion. Justice League, even though it was 4 hours, which it doesn't faze me. I've watched that movie tons of times. And now, nothing. I'm so disgusted. I want my Justice League 2 and 3, bro. I'm so disgusted. Like, come on, James, you just went, oh, I got the power. And you do. I'm not saying you don't, you do. And now we got nothing. I know Zack is not coming back because he's excited on doing his Rebel Moon. I'm sure that's going to be pretty funky from all the Zack Snyder's movies I've seen. Please. So, Henry's gone. No, let me put in superhero names. Zack Snyder's Superman's gone. Zack's Batman is gone. Not sure about Wonder Woman. Zack Snyder's Aquaman's gone. Cyborg been gone. Black Adam is gone. Shazam is gone. It's like, what do we have left? We got nothing. But the Suicide Squad's still around, as well as the Peacemaker, because I heard he's making another season. So that's still around. Now, here's the question. Margie, is she still going to be as Harley Quinn? Because I heard this chick now want money. And we all know companies that hear about money, they're like, well, we're trying to save money to make it better. So, there you have it. The Snyderverse is gone. So it's going to be, like I said, it's an NWO, new world order of DC Studios. And they want to do things with younger people because I can see where that's going. They want to do somebody younger for the next 10 years. They don't want the older. But if you put up a poster of Kingdom Come, that's kind of like the older. So, you know, it's like, okay, why are you doing that? And you get rid of these actors. You know what I mean? It's just stupid. But thank you guys for watching the video. Thank you for understanding where I'm coming from. Some of you. So that's all I got right now. Thank you for the movie talk. Next time, guys, I'll see you later, all right? Have a good one. Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year's. Let's go for next year. And I pray to God these movies are going to be awesome next year. All right, guys. See you later. Whoa!